Hi everyone, I'm Alan Walker, and right now I'm at the Fat Cat Studios here in Oslo, Norway, and I'm here with my co-producer, Anders Froen, known as Mood Melodies.
Yeah, we're going to look at Alan's smash alone, so let's take a look.
If this night is not forever, at least we are together. I know I'm not alone, I know I'm not alone.
So, right now we're going to look into my latest single, Alone, and it's pretty much a single that was created a couple months ago, and it's featured with Nuni Bao. She's a Swedish vocalist, and she has a fantastic voice, and yeah, let's get into it.
We can start with the verse track, basically, and the guitars, maybe?
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So what we've done is pretty much that we've been layering up a bunch of guitars, both like we have been like previously been recording and also reused, and also we've just been pretty much programming them all together, and it's got a pretty neat sound, and yeah, it's pretty unique, I would say.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. There's actually a lot of guitars stacked on top of each other. Right now we're just looking at a stem, but I think this was like probably 7 or 8 takes. Kind of sounds like this. And then it's like another guitar going on top. So that's basically the foundation of the verse, basically, with the chords. Yeah, so when we did the guitars, we actually started with me and another writer, Jasper, playing just single notes, chopping them together, and making it into a fake recording. That sounded pretty cool, but we wanted additional guitars to make it more real sounding. So we actually had a real guitarist come in, who's somebody that could actually play, and stacked on top of that. So it's actually both guitars. And with this one, the special guitar, I think it's true like an, let me listen there real quick. So this one is like single shots, just chopped up on the grid and treated with like an effect and like a ton of like Tora Verb, Echo Boy, and like this pedal this guitarist had, basically. And all together, it sounds like this, which is pretty cool. And all the amps are just like guitar rig, so it's nothing special. It's just the regular stuff, basically. Yeah, into the track, is actually, we actually had the full thing going on, like a full intro, and then we just decided, I think Alan took one of the guitar notes, reversed it, and then we put some bit crushing with like an automation going into it. It kind of sounds like this, which made it pretty cool and like straight to the point, which I think was cool.
It really helps to get that in medias res. I think that's what I call it. Like, you get straight to action in the beginning of the track. And I think it's pretty cool because it's catching the listener right like that.
Yeah, pretty much.
And with all the guitars, we also layered them with a piano that we've recorded in the studio. And we also to reverse this, and it actually got a pretty powerful sound, and also, I don't know, I would say like it made also like the guitars way more powerful.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. So it's actually a real grand piano, not just a Nexus patch. I think that's just a straight recording with no effects. I think we compressed it on the way in with some LA-2As, I think.
Yeah, probably, but yeah, like it's just so good sounding because
yeah, it sounds great.
You don't have that, I don't know, digital sound in it.
So the session is so big. So right now, this is just the track, not even the vocal session. And this vocal session, I mean, this beat session right now with just instrumental is probably 130 something tracks. And it's still stemmed down a lot. So I think the total session with just the track was 200 tracks, which sounds crazy, but it kind of made sense when we made it. So this one was actually, I think, 2 or 3 different tracks, one with the reverse piano and one with the actual real piano, just going straight, just the chords. And then I think you had some of these intro voices, which is just either Nuni's voice or some Kashmir from the Kashmir pack. I can't remember these ones.
Just vocal chops there.
Yeah. That's the same thing again, just like Echo Boy, R-Verb, some cutting on the EQ, and Alter Boy, giving it more like a, you know, I don't know what you call it.
Well, with those, we kind of like create our own vocal plugs, and yeah, this is also very helpful because it's also filling filling up the empty room that we have in, for example, the intro of the track where we have them.
Yeah. We also introduce more vocal chops and like those kind of things further into the track, so it's probably like 10 of them in total. So when we find a sound, most of the time we just found a sample that sounds cool, or just recorded ourselves. But most of the time we changed the key. Like this track was probably, we probably changed the tempo and the key probably 5 times, so to like fit the vocal and the drop.
Yeah.
So we just have this feature right here, the transpose feature, like the elastic audio. So you can just do real fast. You can do like, you can, you know, pitch it really fast.
And that's a pretty cool feature. I mean,
one of the great things with Cubase, I think.
Yeah, it really helps.
Yeah, pretty much. Next thing in the verse is the bass patch. Super simple thing going on, just a silent one. I think that's the same patch that we used on Sing Me to Sleep 2, I believe.
Yeah, I think so. And I think that's, again, like it's reflecting on the sound that I'm trying to establish with Alan Walker. And that's to not mainly just repeat the same sounds, but also to create that signature sound.
Yeah, 100%. Got some decapitation going on, not a lot. Filter down a little bit. Well, actually nothing at all. Next patch is just pads. Typical Nexus voice pad, which is bounced audio, so I don't know what it is. I think it was like, was it rev? Output rev?
I can't even remember. This project is so huge. Like, I think it's one of the biggest ones.
I never worked on a song with so many tracks. It's kind of crazy. I don't even almost remember all the sounds. These ones are just more like pluck sounds. I believe this one was from the Cashmere one.
Yeah, it kind of sounds like it.
Yeah.
But like, yeah, the Cashmere pack is so fantastic, right?
It's so good. And all together, it sounds like this. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I think it's no drums in the... Yeah, no, basically no drums, just some small snaps and stuff. That's pretty much a verse. So we can transition into the next section. And this section gets actually way more advanced than I think people even realize, because it's so many layers and it just keeps on transition. So I think the guitar disappears. Yeah.
The guitar is a really, really awesome part, but like you barely hear it when you listen to the original track or the final result.
Yeah.
And it's actually pretty cool because it's pretty much just the same as in the intro. And yeah.
So here, this was actually another guitarist that I think this was like right. I think we even sent the song to like mastering, and then we're like, oh, we need another element on. This was like way overdue. We should like already deliver the master. And then we were talking on the phone, I think, and Alan was like, bro, we need something more to like build it even more. And we're like, okay, let's try like this, like another guy I know is like good with reggae. So we just like recorded some other guitars. Yeah, so these are just the reggae guitars. It's layered 3 times, just simple compression on the single ones. And on the bus we have more compression, reverb, and sidechain with kickstart. Just first setting 100%. Something Alan taught me, just make it, you know, do it simple. There's no reason to like tweak something just to tweak it. And it sounds like this. And then there's another layer with a one-noter.
Yeah, that really fills it up, because the one-noter, I think like it's really magical because it's so powerful and it gives more feeling to the whole guitar melody.
Yeah, and it gives that like, it makes the anticipation of something's gonna happen. So the one-noter goes like this. And same thing, just super simple compression and tour reverb and kickstart again. Filtered up with like, it's getting more and more reverb and yeah, pretty much. Then you have the bass line, which is a real bass. That's just a real bass, just chopped together so it's more tight. All together sounds like this. Which is pretty cool. And then I think you had that brass sample again from the Kashmir pack, I think. Wasn't that from the Kashmir pack?
I don't know, we have so much from Kashmir, like...
Yeah. Either Vengeance or Kashmir, one of them, I think, and that one sounds like this. And then, you know, that all together sounds pretty cool. Like a lot of real sounding instruments with the synths, and with the synths, these are, I think... Yeah, this is a combination of like a lot of patches. So we can just scroll through real fast. Yeah. So this is the patch.
That's pretty much the same one that I've been using in, for example, Fade, Faded, Sing to Sleep, and yeah, and now Alone.
Yeah, and it's like a patch that's been recycled for every single song. But it's a great patch though. It sounds really good. I love this patch. So that's like the almost the foundation of this part. And it's a Nexus patch that you can't even almost hear a difference. And then next one is same thing with this one. This is also like one of the original super Alan Walker patches he had from like day one.
And that one has a really like powerful it's really meaningful for like the whole Alan Walker sound. Like I mean. That one, for example, the chord sound and the solid that I'm always using. I think that these two are the main sounds that you listen to or hear in an Alan Walker song, and also the infamous square lead from Nexus.
Yeah.
Yeah, that one was inspired by, for example, K301. And he actually put out tutorials on how to create, like, for example, patches in the same style as he does. And what I've done is pretty much put a lot of voices and like made sure like it gets that I don't know, like I can't remember the name, but yeah, it's soul feeling and all together like. It has this kind of like crispy sounding. And yeah, it's really powerful and yeah. And with this, together with a kind of like a crispy sound, a soul lead, it really helps to make the whole song more powerful. And it's also pretty cool to base my songs on just pretty much two basic sounds.
So those are three main sounds, stacked together the two super Alan Walker patches from day one, and then with the Nexus patch. Then is another Nexus patch. Nothing is really done with it, other than sidechain again.
Yeah.
Then it's another patch, muted guitars too. Super Alan Walker patch in every single song, I think, right?
Yeah, that's a sound that's actually well known for using in, for example, the original of Fade. And that just had like the muted guitars layered with the solid, and altogether it sounded pretty simple, but at the same time, pretty good.
Yeah, so this is the muted guitar. And then all together with the other sounds. And then also the guitars. Yeah, so that's pretty much that section. The other sounds are just the sounds transitioning through from the verse. Same pad, same silent low bass. And then the last sound, that's the like a top line melody, which is the Nexus, standard Nexus patch.
Yeah, it's the infamous attack lead 3 that a lot of people probably know about, especially the ones that are using Nexus. But yeah, it's pretty cool because it's a simple sound, and it's really cool to actually use something that people may be familiar with in the song as well.
Yeah, I really get that, you know, it feels gaming when I hear it, you know? It feels like it's, it just sounds Walker. Even though it's like overused sounds, I think the great thing is that you were able early on to use sounds that a lot of people use, but it still sounded new, which I think is special. And then we obviously stacked that with like real instruments and all that, but still, it makes sense in the big picture. So that sound sounds like this. Yeah, that's pretty much that section as far as the synths. And I think we have a lot of drums in this section too. We can actually just listen to those by themselves. Let's see. So this is into that part.
Kashmir.
He's
everywhere. He's a really, I would say he's one of my biggest inspirations.
And that's pretty much the drums building into the, there's a lot of layer of different loops, some more organic sounding kicks, like a stomp kick, all together. Pretty cool, pretty simple, but pretty cool. So these drum samples come from, I think, one of them are Kashmir, another one.
So, yeah.
Yeah. I think one of them are actually a real kick drum recorded in that the studio we made the song in. This one is a loop from either Vengeance or Kashmir. I'm not sure.
I would guess it's Kashmir. Hey, it sounds so good.
Yeah. This one I think is that sound. Makes great samples, this one. This is just a loop from their pack, I think. Yeah. So this is, you know, as you can see, we have a lot of samples. I think we have, between me and Alan, we had like 700 or 800 gigabytes of samples. So we have a lot of drum sounds and loops. So that's why we sometimes don't know where it's from, because, you know, we buy a lot of samples, and we buy them too, by the way. So the fill into the drop, the last drum sounding like this. That was something you had, I think.
I've been a big fan of using, for example, drum loops just before the drop, and I feel like, what if I make this kind of like a signature sound? And I don't know, like I've been focusing a lot about signature sound when I make my songs, and for example, you also have like the triplet melodies, and you all have like two different drops. Then that's something that I always focus a lot on. And for example, the drum loops just before the drop, and I think that's a pretty cool way on introducing or letting the listeners know that now you're going into probably like the main chorus of a song or like the drop.
Yeah, it gives it more impact for sure. I can also see here we had two more variations, because this was one of the parts we really struggled with, because the one Alan originally had on Fade and Fader, for instance, was such a great sounding drum fill. And on Sing Me to Sleep, we struggled with it too. So we actually went to the studio, and for the Sing Me to Sleep one, we actually recorded a real drummer. And that was actually worked pretty well. On this one, we couldn't really find, I think we tried 20, 30 different fills. This was one of the ones.
It's just back and forward.
Yeah, back and forward between Cubase and Fruity Loops, like all the time. This was what another alternative we didn't use. And this is the third alternative we didn't use. Yeah, I'm glad we used the one we used, listening back. So that's pretty much the build chorus part. Next part is the drop, and I would say this part is the one we worked a lot on, especially in the studio.
Yeah, it's been really, really much back and forward there. If you look at the behind the scenes on YouTube, then you can see like the other producer we've been working with, Jasper, and he's like, Alan just sits in the studio with his headsets on, and just and Anders and Jasper is wondering what is he doing, and at that time as well, I was trying to figure out how can we make this drop melody, and just solve this problem once for all, and I just sat there, and I don't know how many attempts, but it definitely took about 10 to 30 or more, I guess.
Like, I think you played me like 10 or 15 at least, and I think I made like 5 or 10. We couldn't really figure it out, and then it was like, oh, maybe this is cool, you know? And as you can see here, this is just on this session, it's 42.0. So you can imagine how many versions we've been going through, and I think he has, 20, 30 versions on his computer. So it was kind of a struggle finding it, but when you just played it, the final one, we were all like in the studio, like, wow, we have the drop. And it's like, it sounds sick, and it sounds a little different, sounds Walker, but still sounds, sounds different at the same time from Singing to Sleep and Faded, but still fits.
Well, what I think about this version and the final version, what really makes this song work, and the reason why we went for it as well, is because the melody is so unique. It has this kind of like a bouncy feeling to it, and at the same time as you're using it, like the triplet melody on pretty much every bar in the melody or the chord progression. And I think that's what's making the whole song so much more unique. It's not this usual sound that you hear every day, even though it's the basic four chord progression. But
It feels bouncy and cool. And we were trying to convince each other, like when we played earlier versions of the drop, we were like, oh, this is cool, isn't it? And they were like, we kind of knew we didn't have it. But when he played that version, all of us, Jay Borgen, Nooni Bao, Alan, and myself, were all like looking at each other like, wow, this is it. And then our manager, was also a co-writer on the song, Gunner, came into the studio. He heard it, like, wow, this is it. And then we kind of just knew, I think, and just worked on it from there. That's a drop. Started with, like we said, the main, main MIDI file, and then trying to find different sounds. And when, we jumped back and forth. So when when Alan had the first core of the melody, which is just think like a piano patch. Then we both of us jumped on our, different computers on headsets and just scroll through sounds we liked, some sounds we made, some sounds we just found from like presets. And that's a huge part of the reason why it looks like this. And this is actually even stemmed down, so the drop is probably 30 sounds just in synths, which is it's super unnecessary and super, I don't even know how it got there, but at the same time I think the final product sounds good, so we just kept all of them. I don't know how it kind of happened that way. So it's just a stack of synths. I think the main one, which is again the main, the patch we talked about in the pre, the lush sound, same thing with the electro sound, these two sounds. So that's like the foundation of the chords, the Alan Walker sounds from also Faded and Sing Me to Sleep.
And they also sound pretty good together, and also with the rest of the sounds in the whole track.
Yeah, kind of blends real well. Then we have the square lead. So actually all these three sounds are used in Sing Me to Sleep, Faded, Fade, everything. Next sound is also...
Yeah, that's from the Hardstyle pack. That's something new that I discovered. From a friend of mine from Chile. And he's also always been using that kind of sound, and I felt like, why not try it out, because it's such a powerful, it's called Cerro Crisp, and it also has this very powerful crispy sound pretty much, and it really really helped to make the drop more powerful.
Yeah. And I was very skeptical too to getting the hard style pack. That was like one of the few Nexus expansions I never bought. And he was like, "Oh, you gotta get it." And I was like, "Hard style, that's not really my thing." But it sounds really good and got some great sounds in it. So I was actually surprised. We've been using that for other genres too. It's a great pack.
Mm.
Next sound is some hard style too.
Yeah, I just dug through like the whole hard style expansion from Nexus and. Most people maybe don't know, like there's so many good sounds in maybe like these sound expansions from Nexus that's maybe like under a kind of like a hip hop, if you may not like hip hop, where like it may be full of sounds that could actually fit perfectly to your songs.
Yeah.
And a good example is me with the Hearthstone expansion packs. Like Hearthstone is not my style, but the sounds really really fit well.
Yeah, 100%. Altogether, these. That sounds like this, which is really the core of the chords and the melody. And then it's the bass line, which is, and guitars, which is a lot of sounds too. The main sound, same thing again. This is bounced audio, but this is just a silent pack, also used in Faded, Sing to Sleep, Fade, etc.
Mm.
And then it's that stacked with this one, also silent. Stacked with this one, stacked with the real guitar, I think, or maybe trillion, or is it a real one? Yeah, I don't remember.
It's hard to say, but all of those come put together, like when I'm like the basic saw like basses, it's really good, and it may sound really simple, but like I would say, sometimes what's simple is what's best. And yeah. That's what I really think about, like, for example, Fade and Faded, Sing Me to Sleep and Alone. Like, even though, like, the song may be simple, but that doesn't mean, like, it's not good.
Yeah. These are... This is a guitar bass. Another sound. That's a whole pack, and with the synths, that sounds like this. Sounds pretty cool, sounds pretty full. And then this is, I think this is a combination of Arturia and a Moog, which is stemmed down, it sounds like this. Just various, I think like two or three Arturia patches and one real Moog, I think. All just stacked together. We had to stem it down because the session was too big. So we, yeah, couldn't really get around that. Then it's the drop top melody, which is also a lot of patches. Swedish House, Volume 2, same thing. Electro House. Yeah, all together they sound like this.
And also on the second part of the drop, we also introduced the second melody, which is also something I always like to have a variation in the melodies, because I feel like you can easily get tired if there's not something new that's happening in the song. And that's why, halfway in the drop, you get introduced to a brand new melody, a brand new top melody to give you something unexpected, pretty much. And I would say that it really helps. And also, we have this pluck-ish sound from the Deep House expansion pack in Nexus, the DG Droplets, I think it's called. And I think that one really helps to give that more plucky sound in the whole drop, and also, yeah, you make it more powerful.
So that kind of sounds like this. Four sounds, more Nexus, one Tau actually. That sounds like this. It's sounds pretty cool with everything. And then on the second half, when those are introduced, it's also a real guitar introduced. Sounds like this. It's played, but it's really played fake, like chord by chord and then chopped together, because it was played by a person who can't play guitar. And then...
Not me.
And all together, it sounds like this.
At the very end there, you can hear that digi droplet that I was talking about. What I used to do when it comes to putting all the sounds together is also either like just adjust the volume and also try to EQ it right and compress it, whatever that it really like takes to make them fit together. But first, like when I try to find the sounds that I want to use in a song, then I just pretty much scroll through, for example, Nexus, open up a random expansion pack and just find a random one and try to find it, see or hear if it fits with the whole song itself.
So yeah, we have this extra bar after the drop, I think it's one bar.
Hmm.
And also something we had to go back and forth on a lot, because we had four bars at one point, we had just straight into the verse. And it felt good to just have one bar just to kind of clear it and then go into the verse, because I think it was overlapping with the vocal or something.
Yeah, because it could easily like feel like there was too much going on, like we're just coming right from the drop and then boom, right into the verse again.
Yeah, definitely felt a little rushed, so we decided on one.
Yeah, bar. And then we got like maybe a 2 second break and then you continue.
Yeah. Let's see. Yeah, that's basically just that one. Yeah, same sound as this one, I think.
Mm.
No, that one. I don't know what that's
the digi droplet from Nexus, the Deep House. Like, I don't know, right? It's been one of my favorite plucks.
Sounds really cool. That's Nexus.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then we're transitioning into the second verse. Same thing as the first one. We just have drums going on from the top. And more guitars, of course, are introduced. So we have the foundation, like the first verse, which is basically this. But on this second verse, to kind of move the track along, because we had it the same way for the longest. And then this was some of the last elements, because I think we had a session in Bergen, Alan's hometown, and we were like tweaking the details, and we were like saying that like it sounds really good, but we feel like the track is slowing down, or like it needs to progress somewhere, not to be boring.
Mm.
So I think did we have that guitar player in Bergen, or was that Oslo? I can't remember.
It was here in Oslo.
Okay, yeah. So we recorded these guitars. Very little processing on, just simple EQ and compression, reverb, and more compression, just low cutting the guitars. Nothing extraordinary at all. Let's see what's more is introduced. So yeah, on the second verse is more. So this is actually Nuni's voice from the demo recording that's introduced, together with more of these sounds. Just to transition it. And then the verse pluck, I mean the verse lush and the verse electro sound from the first build and drop continues together with the muted guitar, yeah. And another sound. So those sounds like this. Bassline. Really all the same sounds that's already used in the track, just to like, you know, transition the track and progress the track. Together with all these, it sounds like this.
Then there's something wrong with this island. So I one after I show you guys it. It's just the cutoff is up.
Alright, and what's the next part we should go to?
That's probably vocal chops.
Yeah, chop part. Same sounds. With actually more vocals, let's see. So the vocal chop part is a new section introduced. Has this pad. And that's just Nuni's vocals reversed with a lot of sidechain together with these vocals. This one is an interesting one. So this one sounds like nothing. That little track, that little stem right there by itself was in a separate session, and that's more than 40 vocals in just that little thing. With Nuni, the vocalist, just singing different harmonies and stacking them like 8 times on each harmony, and that sounds like this. Probably took us 3 hours just to do that.
But it sounds so nice.
Yeah, and you can't even hear it in the final version. And then it's a real bass, I think. Yeah, real bass. Then it's this one. Clark, and then this one.
That one is from the Kashmir pack.
That's definitely Kashmir.
And it just fits the song perfectly.
And all those together sounds like... pretty much it in that section, except of course the main chop part, which is this. So that's what's this. These are just reversed. And this is obviously just the stems bounce down again, just to save power. So I think we had more effects on these. And I also think, those are from the actual, I think that's Nuni's vocals.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Yeah, so this vocal chop, the top line session with the vocal chops, is a combination of, it's Nuni's vocals, the vocalists, and then it's Little Altar Boy with different settings, it seems, on each one. And then it's just chopped on the grid with using Elastic Audio right here. Which you can just chop different sections of the vocals up and down and make it sound like this. And then some, you know, some drum hits also, making it more. And then all together with all those other sounds, it sounds like this. That's pretty much it. New build up with the same sounds.
I don't know, it's the same all over again.
Yeah, same all over again. Only difference though, I think, is one different thing.
That's near the ending.
Yeah, so in the ending here, it's more, even more sounds introduced in the drop. Some sounds just stacking more. So the first part of this last drop is the same thing. Yeah, it's all the same thing, but more sounds are introduced. And also strings and more vocals. So those are like on this section right here in the final drop, where it's like a double drop. So that section, that was one of Alan's, you know, special Nexus sounds.
Yeah, like Nexus is life.
It's awesome. And that's this one. That's, which one is that again? I bounced it down, so I don't have the...
That is the...
The ARP one?
Yeah, I know what one it is. Actually, I can open it. If you open Nexus, I'll find it. I think I know where it is.
It's Broken Saw, is it?
This one.
Hold on, let me just...
You can't play? Oh, oh.
If you just do like this.
Oh, there we go. Yeah, it is actually an arp, but you remove the arp part, and then you got yourself a pretty cool lead, because right now, if you... And... yeah, and then you can just go here, and then you go... Yeah.
Yeah, so that's that sound. I think there's another one here too. Let's see, this one. That's a new sound too. Also with some Nexus patch from like Trap or something.
Yeah, it sounds like it.
Yeah, and then with that sound, and then also strings, more piano, more guitars, these sounds are introduced in the final drop. Those strings are from Nexus Hollywood, and the other string part earlier in the song is from East West, I think.
Mm. Yeah,
and that's pretty much the track.
Yeah, I love for example, movie soundtracks, and just having that influence and be able to put it in the song is just absolutely great. And but you barely hear it, but like it has that kind of like small touch from just inspiration from, for example, Hans Zimmer or Steve Jablonski, and yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah, that's definitely something Alan does a lot, like especially now when he's like on tour, like in Europe, Asia, America, whatever, like all the time. We can't be in the studio every day anymore, so what we a lot of times do, we just send each other ideas like online. And a lot of times he sends me ideas that sounds like a score, but it's really like an amazing song hidden there. It's just with strings and pianos. And when we actually work on songs, like it was like a classical piece for a long time before it transitions into like a production like this. Yeah, so now we can transition into the drop drums, which is fairly straightforward. Kick.
Where I got this sample from, I can't recall, but the reason why I really like these kind of kicks is because I've always been really, really fascinated by, like, for example, the old school techno sounds, and also, for example, hands-up songs, and I just, I don't know, it was the style that I started with, and the style I've been trying to keep on producing, but as at the same time, have that 2016 or 2017, I mean, touch to it, and it really helps, like, because the kick is not too powerful and it's not too weak as well, and yeah, it's just something fairly simple, I would say, layered up with a couple of claps and hi-hats and everything. As of now, I'm using a lot of, for example, the plugin Kickstart to sidechain my songs, and what Kickstart really helps me with doing is that it really gives a very smooth but a very powerful sidechain, and that really helps me to get out the highs and lows and yeah, pretty much everything.
So as far as the hats and the percussion, we have this sound just on the offbeat, totally on the grid, same sample as, you know, fade. Sing to sleep, just recycle again.
That's what we do.
I think it's actually the same thing with the kick. That's either the kick from Faded or Sing to Sleep.
Sure, I think it's the same as Sing to Sleep.
Yeah. Crashes. And then we have the percussion loop. Then more tambourine loop. And then another one.
And then we also had, like, for example, the percussion that I just played for in that small break. And also what I always do is have these kind of like small fill-ins to, instead of just giving people the feeling of that everything is being repeated, it's also something new. And that's what's also pretty cool about that small, like, percussion role, and it has such a huge effect.
And yeah, all together the drum sounds like this. Pretty much. Yeah. That's basically it. So this is the demo vocal session. The actual vocals were recorded in Pro Tools, but it's the same. It's the same setup, basically, just more vocals in the actual finished vocal. So we have a lead going in the verse, lead in the chorus, stacked four times with two more stacks just doing whispers. That kind of sounds like this with just the lead.
These we are together.
Four backgrounds.
I know I'm not alone.
Two whispers with the lead sounds
like I know I'm not alone.
So that's the main, and then we have a scream vocal on the end on like the tagline or the main hook, going like this.
I know I'm not alone.
It kind of sounds like a zombie apocalypse or something.
Sounds pretty weird, but those are actually used as a stem in the final version. Those from the demo session.
Yeah, that's what's pretty cool about like everything about making music, because it can sound super weird, but when you put everything all together, it sounds pretty insane.
A lot of these sounds are not the best sounds. It's just in the final package it makes sense. Same thing like you said with the kick by itself might not be the best kick, but in the total finished product it really fits. And I think that's important, because if you solo stuff too much, same thing when you're mixing, like you can get lost into that sound and lose track of the whole picture, because nobody's going to care about how stuff sounds solo versus how it actually sounds in the finished mix. And then these are just the fake kids vocals. So these are actually not kids. These are just us, Nuni, Jasper, Alan, and myself in the studio, just trying to be kids on different takes to like stack the chorus.
Old man becoming children
right. Core. Yeah, and we actually ended up recording an actual kid choir like 40 times, like stacking it a lot, like over and over, because we only had four kids and we wanted to make it sound, you know, make it sound and seem like it was like a huge choir in a church or something. And then we had Nuni also record, because she was in LA at the time, so we had her record additional fake gang vocals too. So that whole part, the main vocals are really simple. It's just a lead, four backgrounds, and two whisper vocals, only seven vocals in the chorus. But then with the choir, or like the gang vocals, it's probably 60, 70 vocals. So there's a lot of vocals doing the same thing over and over. No autotune, though, on those vocals. On the main vocals, we have autotune, cutting the bottom. Then we have compression, waves, one multiband compressor. And then just doing the CLA. This one is not used on the finished one, but we send wet stems to the mixer. So when we send to mix or mastering, it's our session. So it's basically the wet stems. So the rough mix and the final mix is fairly close. It's just like taking the last 5 or 10%. And as far as the other vocals, so these are obviously tuned also with either Melodyne or Variaudio in Cubase. But with the gang vocals, for instance, or the scream vocals, it's nothing on the takes. None of the takes. So a lot of them sound kind of, if we just listen to one in solo and take the effects off, like a single one, for instance, sounds like this. It sounds really bad, like in solo. Right? That's how all of them really sounds. But then like in total, they sound pretty cool, and then they're just compressed and verbed up on the bus instead of just on the single takes.
Night is not forever, at least we are together. I know I'm not alone, I know I'm not alone.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Yeah, to record like or to make us sound that way, we didn't even pitch it. Like it's pretty funny because we I don't know, like there's been so many shots of just us standing in the booth, just screaming the lyrics as loud or as as making, high as we can. And just to make sure that we sound like children, and then we just put everything together, and it sounds pretty neat.
And we also actually, even this is super weird, but we had like two takes where we sound like old man to be like the bad sounding off pitch teacher in there. So it's actually like a couple of ones sound like old man in there too, at least in the finished version. And then obviously like the 30-40 takes of the actual children, and then all stacked together, it sounds like the finished product, pretty much. Yeah.
Yeah, it's time to wrap up everything. I hope you all enjoyed watching the behind the scenes and the making of Alone. And I hope you all learned something. And thank you so much for watching.